Welcome to Nursing Gyan with Neola. This channel is specially for you if you are planning to appear for nursing licensure exams such as DHA, MOH, NHAD and so on. In these video sessions, we'll be discussing various topics which I think would be expected in the exams. So without wasting any much time, let's start with today's topic. And today's topic is Maslow's Hierarchy of Human Needs. Maslow's hierarchy is very beautifully depicted in this pyramid. It was first introduced in 1943 by Abraham Maslow in his paper, A Theory of Human Motivation. Later, it was refined in 1954 with his book, Motivation and Personality. Since then, this has become a popular subject in sociology training as well as management training. The first four needs from the bottom, physiological or basic needs, safety or security needs, social or love and belonging needs, as well as esteem needs. These four are considered to be deficiency needs. Because if a person is deprived of these needs, then he feels unsatisfied. So satisfaction is important. A person cannot approach to the topmost aspect of the pyramid if the needs in the bottom of the pyramid is not fulfilled. So what happens if the person is deprived of these needs is he will be unsatisfied, or it can lead to unpleasant feelings or consequences. So Maslow has designed this 5-stage model to describe that these four needs are very basic needs that is required by a human being. And when these basic needs are fulfilled, only then the person can approach to the more complex need at the topmost layer of the pyramid, that is self-actualization need. So when these basic needs are fulfilled, a person has everything in his life, and when he moves to the self-actualization aspect of the pyramid, that means he has found a meaning to his life. And as every individual is unique in his own way, then a person can move into different direction. So now that you know the concept of the pyramid, let's learn each needs in detail. So the first stage is physiologic or basic needs, or it's otherwise called as biological needs. So the example for these needs are the air that we breathe. Without air, we cannot survive. Without oxygen, we cannot survive. Food that we eat, we cannot stay hungry for a long time. So that is also a basic need. If you're thirsty, you drink water. Water is a basic need. Then we have shelter. To stay somewhere, you need a shelter. You need clothes to wear. You need sleep. So all these are basic needs. If these needs are not fulfilled, you cannot move further to the second aspect of the pyramid, that is safety or security need. So when your physiologic or basic needs are fulfilled, you move on to the second aspect of the pyramid, that is safety or security needs. When you own something such as your own body, your resources, your family, then you need to secure it for the safety. So in this, basically, what we do is we secure our body, we secure our resources, we get a job and we have to secure it for future. We secure our morality, our values, our customs. We secure our family. We think of safety of our health, and we secure our property that we own. So only when you secure all these things and all these needs are fulfilled, then you can move on to the next stage, that is social or love and belonging needs. Now we have fulfilled safety as well as security needs. What we are going to do is now we are going to move to social or love and belonging needs. So in this stage, the main focus is on building relationship with people. So you build a relationship with your family members. You find a person whom you love, who shares similar interests with you, your wife, your husband, your children. You build a sort of trust with them. You love them. You build a sort of affection with them. So this is what happens in social or love and belonging needs. your friends, you find a job and in the second aspect. So when you find a job, obviously you will meet a lot of people with similar interests, and then you build a relationship with them, you make friendship with them. And this is what happens in the third stage. Only when these needs are fulfilled, you move to the next stage, that is esteem needs. So now we are done with the social or love and belonging needs. We are going to move to esteem needs. So when you have a job, when you secure a job, when you have a family, when you own a property, what we need to do, what we need to have? We need to have dominance over it. We need to have confidence. We need to have independence. And we gain respect from others because of the things that we own, we gain a status in the society. So we gain a prestige in the society. So that is how we get respect from others. And we also respect others from the respect that we gain. So this is what happens in esteem needs. You get a confidence, you become independent, you gain respect from others, you give respect to others, as well as you gain status, you achieve things in your life, as well as you possess dominance towards the things that you own. So first four needs from the bottom: physiologic or basic needs, safety or security needs, social or love and belonging needs, as well as esteem needs. These are all basic needs. When these basic needs are fulfilled, you move to the more complex need, that is called self-actualization need. Now we are going to discuss about self-actualization need in detail. So now all these four needs are fulfilled, you're moving to the actual and the complex need of every human's life, and that is self-actualization need. So in self-actualization need, you get to know all the things all the things clearly. In reality, what happens is we find reasons for our personal growth, for our professional growth, and that is through the experiences in life. So when these four needs are fulfilled, you get to know what things you need to have to lead a normal professional as well as personal life. So you find a new meaning to life. You think of having a fulfillment in life. So what happens is you accept the facts that are in front of you, and you assimilate all those facts and inculcate in your life for personal growth, as well as you realize your potential, your capabilities, your morals, your values. You realize them and you make use of them for your personal growth. And when all these needs are fulfilled, you feel a sort of satisfaction. So this is what happens in self-actualization need. And as I have already told you, a person, an individual is unique in his own way, so he can move to different direction based on all the needs that are fulfilled, based on his potentials. So this is the five-stage model that was being designed by Maslow, Abraham Maslow, in 1943, and it beautifully describes all the basic as well as complex needs a human should possess. So with this, I end the topic, and I'm sure that you have gained a lot of knowledge on this topic and everything is clear to you. If you have any further questions, feel free to comment on the comment section. And if you like my session, please like it, share it, as well as subscribe to my channel for further videos. As well as comment on the comment section if you want to know more in detail about these topics. I will always be there to help you with your exam preparations. So until next time, keep watching Nursing Gyan with Neola, and bye-bye.